the second script really soars. I think there's just a lot more action due to the circumstance that's really real, that's written. And I think the fans are going to be really pleased with the new characters that come into the piece and with the heightened element of drama and overcoming wicked. It's going to be just really phenomenal. I play Jorge, who is the head of the scavengers, and I like this guy because he hasn't given up. Number one, he's a bit of a badass, but even more than that, he's a reader. He's a guy who really knows history. He's a guy who has decided to create a world for himself and the folks who follow him, without being part of the bad, wicked, and without being someone who he refuses to be on the run. So he creates a haven for himself by doing some things that could be looked at as reprehensible. You know, people who are getting ready to change, the scavengers who are infected are going to change. He chains them up and uses them as his security, which is very smart. And he creates a place where he can, a lair, a building where that's protected, where he can keep his people safe for a long period of time. I love being on the set with these young people because they're not trying to live up to anything that they've done before. They're not trying to be, you know, they have aspirations to just do what the gig is, what the truth is of the job. So you get actors who come in who are, you know, their reputation precedes them, and they come in and try to act. And really, you just got to be in this story. That's how the story is. So every time I try to put on some airs and try to be someone I'm not, I realize Jorge is a little bit crazy. He's really smart. I allow myself to laugh and be a little bit over the top because this is a guy that, you know, if the end is coming, you know, there's got to be some joy somewhere. And so I've been energized by working with all of our young folks, Dylan and Dex and, you know, Kaya. It's fantastic because they just hit it. And it's really nice and refreshing to be with folks who aren't trying to be anything but what they are. And it's great. Rosa Salazar is a firecracker. She's nonstop. And I loved it when Wes told me that he cast her and that he was, you know, taking a chance on this young actress. She comes from her gut. From the moment I met her, we had a great synchronicity. I really felt as if she was someone who also was paying attention and wanted to be here. And wants to not only learn, but has a complete control of her faculty and her own intelligence and knowledge. Wes sees the film. He's not attached to just what he sees. He's able to allow his vision to morph and change, but he sees the reality of what the frame and what he wants to see and what he wants to believe. And I think that makes for a really incredible director. You know, a guy who comes in having done his homework technically and could do this whole movie without any actors at all. He could do it all on his computer. That's the kind of genius he is, right? But we want to see it come to life with real faces and all that. But he is really malleable in regard to listening to his actors to help them find the reality of the character. And for an actor, that's where we begin. And then everything else is cake. It really is. So it's been a joy to work with him. It really is. You know, he is like a little kid, and that kind of exuberance, when he's on the set, he gets excited when the explosions happen, but he's even as excited when I can always tell when the shot is right, because he's like, he gets, yeah, do another one. And I can tell when it's not really quite the energy where it should be, because he doesn't have that kind of energetic feel. So it's great to have clarity with a director and have someone who's not just walking through it, just, you know, punching the clock. He's looking to make something that is really special and really different and that fulfills his expectation.